Good morning, students. Today we will continue with chapter 4. It is part 2, video number 16 of class 6th, physics. Now we will start with types of friction. There are three types of friction depending on how two surfaces interact with each other. First, static friction, second, sliding friction, third, rolling friction. Static friction. This object is on the surface. This object is at resting position. Force applied is a zero. Even then, at which surface this object is placed, opposite force acting on it, that opposite force we call it as friction. This time, mean when object is at resting state, which type of friction this object has? Static friction. Now, when we apply force, that time this object slide over the surface. When it slide over the surface, even then opposite force develop, that is friction. Then we call it as sliding friction. Third type, rolling friction. When an object is rolling over other, when this object roll over another surface, that time opposite force develop, that time we call that friction as rolling friction. Static friction, it is friction between two surfaces when the object start moving from its state of rest. It is force required to start moving the object. It is maximum force of friction between two surfaces. Interlocking is strong, hence the force required to overcome static friction is more. Sliding friction. It is friction between two surfaces when an object is already in motion over another surface, or object over another object or surface. It is the force required to retain sliding motion at the same speed. Sliding friction is less than static friction. Interlocking is not very strong due to sliding movement. Hence, the force required to overcome sliding friction is less. Rolling friction. It is a friction between two surfaces when an object is rolling over another. It is a force required to retain rolling motion at the same speed. Rolling friction is much less than the sliding friction. Interlocking is weak, hence the force required to overcome rolling friction is much less than the sliding friction, than the static friction. Hence, static friction is more than the sliding friction, and sliding friction is more than the rolling friction. Static friction greater than sliding friction, greater than rolling friction. One example in the book they have given: it will take a lot of force to push a heavy block of concrete from one place to another by sliding it over the ground. But if rollers are placed under the concrete block, the force required is much less, as a concrete block is easily rolled over the surface of the ground. Why? Because the roller turn around like a wheel, taking a heavy concrete block forward. Hence we can say wheels reduce friction. Advantages and disadvantages of friction. Friction act all the time around us, but sometimes it is an advantage or even necessary, while sometimes it is disadvantage. This is the reason that friction is sometimes called unnecessary evil. And some points they have given of advantages and disadvantages of friction. Advantages: friction enable us to walk and run. When we walk, we apply force on the ground, and opposing frictional force prevent us from the slipping, and we are able to walk and run. Friction help us to write and hold things. Friction between pencil and our hand allow us to hold like this a pencil or a pen firmly. Also, friction between tip of pencil and paper help us to write on the paper. Friction produce desired amount of heat. In winter, when we rub our palm vigorously, they become warmer due to the heat produced by friction. When we strike a matchstick against the rough surface, the heat produced by friction lights up the matchstick. Friction allow moving object to slow down or stop when desired. A cycle or a car can be made to stop or slow down by increasing friction between a brake pads and the wheel. Increasing friction. Friction can be increased by making the surface in contact uneven or rough, creating grooves or threads on the rubbing surface. Grooves are shallow depression made on the sole of the shoe to make them uneven. This increases friction while running. Threads are the series of pattern made on the tires. Threads increase the friction between tire and the road, providing a better grip on the road. Applying a coarse substance on contact surface. About kabaddi players, they have given that kabaddi player often rub soil on their hands to increase friction and to get a better grip on the opponent. Gymnasts apply a coarse substance on their hands to increase the friction to get a better grip on bars and beams. Now, disadvantages of friction. Friction causes wear and tear. Friction causes the sole of the shoes and tires of the vehicle to wear out gradually. Moving part of machine of any machine rub against each other and wear out due to friction. They have to be lubricated or may even have to be changed often. Second, friction produces undesired amount of heat. The undesired heat produced by friction cause damage to tires and machine parts. Sometimes at high speed friction produces so much heat that it makes the tire burst on the road. When a mixture grinder is operated for few minutes, its blade heat up due to the friction between the moving parts of the machine. If they are not allowed to cool down, large amount of heat produced can damage the machine parts. Third, friction slows down the object when it is not desired. On muddy road, the friction is so high that is reduce the speed of vehicle considerably. Now, how we can decrease friction? Friction can be decreased by making surfaces in contact even or smooth, by polishing or smoothing, by applying oil or lubricant, by using ball bearing, polishing or smoothing the rubbing surface. Skating rink floor is smoother to ensure that the friction is reduced. It allows the skaters to skate smoothly with less effort. That's why they can skate smoothly. Knives and scissors have smooth edges to reduce friction. Reduce the friction makes cutting easier. If the surface is rough, then it creates a problem for cutting. Applying oil or lubricant on contact surfaces reduce friction. Applying oil on the door images. Lubricant form a thin layer between two rubbing surfaces, therefore smoothing the irregularities. Hence, both the surfaces slide over each other easily. Oil is applied to the door hinges, moving part of the machinery to reduce friction. Using ball bearing and wheels to introduce sliding friction. A heavy object with wheel move easily over another surface as rolling friction is less than the sliding friction. In activity 3, to understand the play of force of friction in an object in motion. See the first one, static friction they have shown in the diagram. On one side spring is attached, force is applied. When we place a book on the table and pull it by using a spring balance, we will note the reading when the book just start moving from the state of rest. This is the magnitude of static friction. Second activity, when we continue to pull a moving book that is a sliding on the table using a spring balance, we will note reading, that is the magnitude of sliding friction. Say part, when we place a pencil or round ball below an object, then pull it using a spring balance, we will note down the reading. This is the magnitude of rolling friction. After performing these three activity to show static friction, sliding friction and rolling friction, what observation we observe? That static friction is more than the sliding friction and sliding friction is more than the rolling friction. Test yourself, fill up force that act opposite to the force applied between two surfaces called friction. Rough surface have dash friction than smooth surface. Move. When two objects start sliding over one another, then interlocking is not very strong. Static friction is dash than the rolling friction. More. Polishing or lubricating a surface, dash friction. Reduce. Note down some question for practice. What is rolling friction? Second, why are wheels reduce friction? Go through the chapter and find out more questions from inside the chapter for the practice.